Hello everyone, this is Ross with Market Traders Daily, and this is today's video analysis for April 24, 2020. Today we're taking a look at the GBP USD Greater British Pound versus the US dollar for today's trade analysis. Past 3 days or so, we've seen the market finding resistance within what has been a downtrend for the past 2 weeks or so. If you look at the right-hand side, the blue trend line, short blue trend line, we've been falling, capping out at the 200 period simple moving average all the way up here near the 126.70-80 level, well, actually 126.30 level, capping out at resistance, falling down over the past couple of weeks, and finding resistance now at the 123.65 level. Numbers are small and hard to see sometimes on the side of the chart anyway. Falling down here and finding resistance past 3 days. Let's actually zoom back in one more time. You see the last 3 days finding resistance, that small yellow shaded area at 123.65. That'll be easier to see when we get down to the 4 hour, but there it is, last 3 days into there. As long as it holds underneath there within the current downtrend, I think we look for short opportunities for this currency pair. I took Fibonacci also from the lowest low down here at the bottom of the red trend line to our most recent high point. And that puts the 236 Fib right here at our yellow shaded areas also. 382 Fib of that range, if we were to see further retracement lower, would be here. The green zone, 121.75 area, 618 of that range would be all the way down here at 118.80. So very interesting for the continuation lower of the current downtrend if we get a sub to sell on the pound dollar. Other side of that, of course, is if it breaks higher, it gets above that same resistance, that yellow shaded area, we could be looking for a turn higher again. But right now, the past couple of days, just holding up between the orange and the yellow shaded area. One other thing that I observed and was looking at here a little bit ago was if I take a trend line and cap it out at this high back here, top of the red trend line, put it underneath these lows right here at the bottom of the black box, you can see how we're settling up underneath of that black line as well, somewhat like a head and shoulders pattern. So very interesting there. I don't know if that'll come to anything, but just thought I'd point that out for you as another indication of resistance right about where we are right now. Let's take it down to the 4 hour time frame. Look at this. Look at the past 2-3 days holding up under that yellow zone. Again, that's 123.80.65 is that yellow shaded area. There's that 236 Fib. Again, as long as it stays underneath there, I think we have opportunities to go short on the intraday. Only if it gets above the yellow zone do I begin looking for it to go up again. Obviously, the next thing we would look for is the breakdown underneath the orange zone, beyond there, underneath the pink zone for further movement lower. I think if you're a buyer, you could be thinking about the orange zone as support, pink zone as support, but of course above the yellow zone would look for it to go up. Obviously, in the past 2 days, buying the orange zone, selling the yellow zone, you could have made a decent amount of profit. So that's something to think about if you're looking for new trade setups on an intraday basis. You could be trading this small range here. In fact, we could take this black box and put it right about here. You can see it bouncing around in there for the past couple of days. I think, again, looking at the daily time frame and what we see as far as the trend, there's a good chance that this takes a resistance and falls back down. Of course, that also means, and we'll look at this later in the trade room, the dollar needs to go up. And it's finding some resistance right now as well. So dollar needs to go up. That's going to improve the chances of this pound dollar going down. We need to see that happening. And we'll look for a volume rollover. We've been talking about that in the live trade room, looking at our volume indicator, looking for a signal or trigger to sell this into resistance if the volume can roll over to bearish from a buy attitude for the pound dollar today.
From Forex Traders Daily, this has been your daily analysis with Ross Mullins. If you would like to get Ross's analysis on all the currency pairs he's watching and all the trades he takes today, join him in his live trade room by clicking on the link below. Please leave any comments you have about today's video in the comments section below.